this is the image I'm gonna work with today. Imagine waking up on a Sunday morning, you just throw your MacBook on the bed and take a photo from above like this one. And then you say, you know what, I'm gonna throw some text here, maybe a cool quote or a lyric, a funny one, and make it look real like it's printed on the bed sheets. But before that, you need some preparation. You need to create a displacement map in Photoshop. To do this, you enter the channels panel and you choose a channel which has the most contrast. You have the red channel, this is the green, and the blue. In my case, the green is what I need. So I right-click on it and choose Duplicate Channel. For document, I just choose New, and you can enter a name here. I will just call it Displacement. Hit OK, and then you can see up here that Photoshop created for me a new document which represents the green channel that I just duplicated. All right, the next step is to blur the image. So Filter, Blur, Gaussian blur. Basically, you need to get rid of any texture, and depending on your image size, you use this slider to choose a low value, making sure that any texture on the photo will not be visible anymore. And for me, in this case, a 3 is a good value. I'm gonna hit OK and save this document anywhere I want. I name it Displacement. I will choose my desktop real quick. The file is saved, and now you can close it. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to my image with this Apple computer. I'm gonna choose the text tool by pressing on T, and first I will choose a 50% gray here. Don't use white, don't use black, use 50% gray. It will look good and realistic in the end, trust me. And I will write here, I have a bed, and then I'm gonna hit a few times enter and write, I have an apple. Apple bed. And guys, just a quick question. Did you enjoy that original PPAP song? I mean, was it fun for you or your kids? For me, it was fun in the beginning. So put your answers in the comment section below just for fun. Come on. Now, right-click on the text layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now go to Filter, Distort, and Displace. These numbers will have to be the same. The higher the value is, the more intense the effect will be. I usually use 5, 7, something like that, but if something does not look as it should be, these are the numbers which need to be changed. Make sure Stretch to Fit and Repeat Edge Pixels are selected, and then hit OK. Photoshop will ask you to select the displacement file that you want to use. I will select the displacement.psd, which I created earlier. Hit OK, and Photoshop has applied the displacement map. Make sure the text layer is selected and change the blending mode to linear burn. Now, if you zoom in on the text, you will see that it's too sharp comparing it to the image. So with the text selected, I will go to Filter, Blur, and then again Gaussian blur, and choose a low blur value. I will choose a 0.5 or 0.6 pixels, and I can check here the preview to see the difference. You can see it here, the edges of the text are a bit softer and they look more realistic. The text looks fine, but it still needs some improvement. I want to see the bedsheet texture a bit more through the letters. So right-click on the text layer and choose Blending Options. And there is this underlying layer section where if I drag this highlight slider to the left, the bright parts of the bedsheets will start to be more visible through the text. But this is a bit too harsh, so I'm gonna bring this back to default and I will press the Alt or Option on a Mac. I will drag again the slider and now the two handles are split and the transition is much softer than before. So I'm gonna hit OK, and the last step is to lower a bit the opacity of this layer to 80% or something like that. So this is the final image. You can see how the letters are following the curved surfaces on the bedsheets. It's awesome. However, never print your bedsheets with this text. If you want, you can check and uncheck the visibility of the displace effect so you can see how the text was before and after. Keep in mind that if you double-click the text layer on its thumbnail, because it's a smart object, the layer will open up and you can modify your text. So for example, I can write in, I love Sundays. Then I press Ctrl S to save the file, and if I go back to my main document, you can see that the text was replaced. And another important thing is that if you want to move or change the size of the text, make sure that after you changed its position or scale, you right-click on the Displace effect and choose Edit Smart Filter. Photoshop will ask you again what's the displacement map file. You hit OK and now the text is adapted on the surface correctly. Otherwise, if you just move the text without readapting it, it will not warp correctly onto the surface underneath. Alright, if this video helped you in any way, smash that like button, subscribe if you don't want to miss anything, and thank you so much for all your comments and feedback on my videos. You are really, really awesome. I'm Chris, keep photoshopping, and catch you in the next one.